Welcome to the Whiteboard Workout for October 2013. So for this workout, we're going to be focusing on speed and explosiveness. Now these are terms that are kind of overused. We hear them often, and they're sexy, they're flashy, right? We love explosive workouts, and we love speed workouts because they're high metabolic demand, and they get really sweaty, and they're really intense, and everything else. But in order to effectively lead a speed, explosive, or a power-based workout, you cannot be doing it under fatigue. So we're setting up this workout where there's plenty of rest and very, very, very short sets. So the duration, very small overall volume, very small intensity, very, very, very high. So it's as hard and as fast as you can go. We're going to choose 6 different exercises. We're going to do each exercise for 4 sets. 4 sets. Now, if you're working with higher caliber athletes, you want to increase the volume to 6 or 8 sets each, that's absolutely fine. 4 is a good number to start off with. For each exercise, in each set, we're going to do 10 seconds and then a 30-second rest. 10 seconds work, 30 seconds rest. Some of the exercises will have a right and left side, so we'll do 2 on the right and 2 on the left. Make sure you are taking the time to warm your athletes up properly. You should have at least a 15 to 20 minute dynamic warm-up to make sure that tissue is ready to go and the nervous system is turned on so that they can move rapidly and effectively right on the first exercise. So the cool thing about this type of workout and this setup is you can choose whatever you want. I'm gonna give you 6 exercises that I like, but you can put any 6 in here you want, which is really, really, really cool. Some of my favorite pieces of equipment for this type of workout or training are things like resistance bands, med balls, the TRX grip trainer, and the Surge by Headstrong Fitness. I think these are all great tools because they do have some load and resistance, but I can keep it light, so I do have a high level of acceleration. Acceleration is very important in all these different exercises. Oh, I forgot battle ropes, because we're gonna be using battle ropes today. That's one of my favorites too. So here's the 6 I chose, but you can choose any 6 that you'd like. We're focusing on exercises that have more of a full body nature and intense demands on power output and overall stability. So we're gonna start off with the TRX grip trainer. We're gonna do reverse paddleboard row. So I'm gonna have my power hand palm down in zone 4 and my base hand palm up in zone 1. This is gonna be a little opposite because it's reverse. So I'm gonna start with my hips extended and the bar pulled down by the side. I'm gonna load down to the hips as I drive the bar out, snap the hips and pull the bar down. We got 10 seconds, hard, fast, driving through the hips, 30 second rest. Stay on that side for your second set and then switch sides for the last 2 sets. So that's exercise 1. Exercise 2, we're gonna go over to our heavy ropes and we're gonna do double arm heavy rope slams. I'm gonna try and set the legs and set the trunk. So not a lot of movement, but set, and just moving through the arms and the shoulders. We're trying to crack the ground and then rip the rope off the ground as hard and as fast as you can. Big, heavy slams and as many as you can do in 10 seconds. After that, we're gonna go over to the Surge. We're gonna grab the neutral grip handles and we're gonna go into a battering ram. So imagine there's a door that you're trying to break down. Think of pushing and driving all the water to that end of the tube and then pulling to drive the water back to the other end of the tube. And then constant push, pull, push, pull. Making sure that we're very stable in the legs and have a nice wide stance. We're gonna do 2 sets on the right, followed by 2 sets on the left. After that, we're gonna go back to the rip trainer and we're gonna do a samurai strike. So this time our power hand will be palmed up in either zone 4 or zone 3. Zone 3 is gonna be a little bit longer lever. It's gonna give you a little bit more resistance. And then our base hand is still palmed down in zone 1. We're gonna load into the hips. We're gonna drive down into the ground, rotating the hips, pivoting the back foot, pushing and pulling, load, drive, load, drive. Think of down and up on this motion and not back and forward. 2 on the right, 2 on the left, 10 seconds with 30 seconds rest in between. After that, we're gonna go back to the rope and we're gonna do rope claps. Setting the legs, setting the trunk as we did before, and then just this strong in and out motion. Pull the ropes in together and then rip them apart as you're going through and keep that nice flow where you're driving and have that constant flow of energy. And then finally, we're gonna finish up back on the Surge and we're gonna go Surge uppercut. So I'm gonna grab the neutral handles again, loading into the hips. I have that same pivot and hip rotation that I did on the TRX rip trainer. And I'm gonna go into a full uppercut, making sure my lead hand comes out away from the body and my close hand turns and keeps towards the shoulders. I rotate through the rib cage. I'm gonna stay all on one side, loading and driving. 10 seconds, rest, 2 sets on the right, followed by 2 sets on the left. So again, those are the 6 I chose for this. You can choose any 6 you want. Med ball slams, deep ball slams, throws, rebounds, different exercises on the rip, different exercises on the row. We have so many different options here. I just really like the format of the 10 seconds work, 30 seconds rest for 4 to 8 sets, whatever volume you want to work into, for about 6 exercises, and that'll take you through a great workout. So I hope you guys enjoyed this one. I hope you get a chance to use it and check it out and like it. if you do, if you like these workouts, be sure to head over to CaseySussman.com and click Join the League of Extraordinary Trainers. That way you'll get access to the Insiders Whiteboard Workout. So those I send out privately once a month, and they're the same format, a little bit more complex, different exercises, plus they have a video of the exercises, so you get a little bit better visual demonstration. So head on over there, make sure to check those out, and I look forward to seeing you guys next month.